So I have to tell you that I'm doing a new book. It'll come out in August. Sex for Dummies is going to come out in a new edition. Especially for some things that I want to talk to younger women, and also some things that I'm very concerned about. I'm very concerned about loneliness, and that's for all ages. And I'm very concerned about, not with this group, because I watch you, but I'm very concerned about that the art of conversation part is going to disappear, because everybody is going to be on their phone, and we have to watch out for that. I'm not saying that we shouldn't use iPhones, but I'm saying be careful. And what I think that in this country, we do have the best scientifically validated data about human sexual functioning, but we still need more research. And we still need to make sure that I learned a new word. What is that when you, there is a word on the internet when you wait for a phone call? What's it called?
Ghosting.
Okay, I learned something new. You see, at the age of 90 and a half, I learn new things. Don't sit there and wait for a phone call. Don't go to bed with anybody that you don't think is really interested in a relationship.
Right.
Because this is going to lead to a lot of disappointments. So loud and clear, if you don't have a relationship, no one night stands, okay? I became a sniper. Watch out, whoever doesn't take a risk, I can still shoot. And then I went to Paris and to study, and to make it very short, I came to this country as a visitor. And then I saw, let me see, I can pick up a master's. And I needed a job. That's important for all of you young people. I did work at Planned Parenthood of New York City. And in those days, Planned Parenthood was not as well known. And these days, especially for a group like you, very important to know that we have to stand up and be counted, that abortion must remain legal, that contraception has to be available. But my biggest risk was that a letter came to Cornell Medical School, where I was being trained as a sex therapist, asking if one of us would address a group of broadcasters on the need for sex education. I did say I never thought that I would do a program, you hear my accent, from the language of Germany first and then Swiss and then Israel and then France. I thought I'd be a consultant to somebody who would do the program. They gave me 15 minutes, a quarter after midnight, and I grabbed it. I didn't just take it, I grabbed it. I thought, I will make a dent, and I'm going to provide sexual literacy. There is one other aspect that I want to tell you, that I believe in that image, and I always carry one with me, of a turtle. A turtle, if it stays in one place, it's safe. Nothing can happen to that turtle. If that turtle wants to move, it has to take a risk. It has to stick its neck out. It could get hurt, but it doesn't move. So all of you 600 women here, from now on, you are going to be turtles and you are going to move.